Bravo.
Henry Greener.
Henry Greener. Lord Henry Greener. Pharaoh Henry Greener.
Oh, Pharaoh. Pharaoh, mate.
Oh, fair, mate.
Welcome back to the Shtick, where we're doing more Purim, because...
Not tonight. I'm having my pyramid. It's the Pharaoh. There he is.
He's not a comedian, but the comedy festival is actually in progress at the moment.
And full swing.
Full swing. You are a full swinger, Warren Wills.
Don Rickles, not appearing.
No. I don't think
Woody
he's
Allen,
alive anymore.
Not coming. No.
Yeah, he's still alive. But
Larry David,
nobody
not coming.
Wants him. He's coming?
Larry David?
Yeah.
Really?
Don't get me started.
No. Okay.
And now, Warren, you're a pianist and a musical director of great note.
I've been called worse. Thank you very much.
Hey, we won't go into it.
Okay.
You're a Mount Scopus boy. You left school and went to London or something. Where did you go?
I resemble that remark. I actually went to Israel for year 82.
82?
No, 1982.
Right.
Chag Purim, Chag Purim. They all know it.
Well, it's obvious the way you're dressed in...
It's a fancy dress today.
Magic.
I would have put a fancy dress on out of
it. It's all done with AI
now.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, we're actually normal, but AI does it all for us.
Okay.
You know that.
I was actually in Princess Kate's photo, actually, and it wasn't AI. I was there in the family shot. I don't know if you saw it.
You were doctored.
I know.
You've been running lots of events all over the world, actually, and you're an international superstar in your own right. I've known you for many, many years, and you've been on the Shtick several times now.
That's it.
But you've been... putting on a show at a place called Amarg Ballroom.
It's Amarg. It's in the Irish Amarg. It's a proper Art Deco 1920s ballroom.
Yep.
Sprung dance floor. In fact, if I ever do a flamenco show, we have the perfect floor for it.
I'll call Kate Sobrano. We'll do it.
Done.
It's called... the one that you've just done
yep.
at the beginning of the month was called Honouring Humanity and Remembering
yep.
Frank, our wonderful friend. What was his name again? I've forgotten the
word. My partner collaborator, Frank Howson, thought he would be better served in the Celestial Writers Guild, taking up his board and place up there and ruffling feathers up there.
Mm.
However, I must share you something. They said, what do you want as a memento of Frank? And I thought, pretty easy one. Both of us are terrible diehards and killed the tragics to the point... That we went to the Palais last year in November to watch the 1966 Grand Final.
Oh.
Says a lot. I know. I must tell you something. Frank Howson was my writer. I first met him when we did Genesis to Broadway.
Yeah.
And then we did the Chopper thing that you know very well, etc.
Yes.
So we were honouring Frank, who departed very sadly about 2 or 3 weeks ago. Now, I'm not making this up, and would I lie to you?
Never.
No. All right. So during the concert, and we were honouring people like Nicholas Winton, who's very well known, I hope, to our listeners, William Cooper, equally well known, Yamo, a Thai heroin superstar who saved Thailand. It's another story for another day. But we got to our section, Remembering Frank. And the great and beautiful Bobby Bright came and we did a number from Chopper. Just as I was introducing it and said, this is for our much prematurely and in absentia, Mr. Frank Howson, and I did the introduction, an entire octave of the piano, I don't make this up, and I wouldn't make this up, stopped working. Weird,
very ghostly.
Huh? Now, not only did it stop working, there was nothing I could do to fix it, except I said, Frank, thank you very much. When we finished that entire...
You stuffed me up again.
When we finished that entire section, it started working. I'm not a conspiracist and I'm not a spiritualist, but go figure.
Go figure.
Yep.
So anyway, now you're doing another event on the 28th of March, also at Amar.
Correct.
Did I pronounce it right this
time? Yes, yep. Thursday at 7 p.m. we have the wonderful Young World Choir, which is multicultural, interfaith, intergenerational. Some people are mobile, some people are not. Some people can see, some people are blind. Everyone performs. We cut the cloth to suit the company. And we have the Young World Choir. We have With One Voice, which is another choir. Again, totally socially inclusive, which is great. And we have a Chinese dance company with whom I'm working. I've got to mention this because they're fantastic. They're called
Tongji.
They're made up. They're from Shanghai. They're all graduates from Shanghai University. I had the great pleasure 2 weeks ago of meeting the head of music theatre from the Shanghai Conservatory, Amy Tang. Hi, Amy. They watch this in Shanghai. You're not censored in China, are you? Hi, Amy.
TikTok. TikTok. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, TikTok.
And
Yep.
And the point about it is not only are they fantastic, they approached me and they said, can we do a program exactly like we did, you know, Nicholas Winton, William Cooper and so on, honouring the role of Shanghai.
Wow.
And as you know the story very well, Shanghai was responsible for saving 20, 30,000 refugee Jews fleeing Nazi persecution.
Correct.
And we are now in partnership with the Chinese, and it's great.
It's very important to remember that. There was one other person we have to mention, and that's Vered Harel, who is a star of the show. She's our star, you know.
Vered. Vered. We, who are not worthy, salute you.
We love you, Vered. So there's also Steph Chen. Is it Chen or Chen?
Steph Chen. Well, yeah. Vered, I can say, shalom, manishma. Steph, I can say, goodbye, fachoy. I think it's Happy New Year. I think so.
Yeah.
She plays a variety of things that you can somehow, as a woman, put in your mouth without being vulgar, if that makes sense.
That's vulgar. It's vulgar in its own right.
Yeah.
Now, besides that event, you have a regular radio show on JAIR called London Beat.
The London Beat, and...
Tell us a little bit about London Beat.
We only do arts. We don't deal with politics. But listen, by its nature, politics is adversarial and divisive.
It is.
And the arts is... inclusive, brings people together. It's a win-win situation.
Win-win.
So, the most recent guest that we've had on, we had Denise Sylvie, the lovely Denise Sylvie. Hi, Denise.
From the Mousetrap?
She's the artistic director. It's been running for 75 years.
No!
And in the last 12 months, the one remaining surviving original cast member, gone.
Gone.
So it was like when the last Munchkin went from the original Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, the last of the
That's
Mohicans.
It. It's gone, gone. That's
I know. So it's been really great to see you back on the shtick, but we must mention Kazakhstan.
Kazakhstan, oh, Kazakhstan, da 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 da. Okay, yeah. I'm big. Well, I'm big anyway, but relatively big in Kazakhstan. Now, Kazakhstan is huge. It's bigger than Australia. It's a massive landmass.
Massive.
It's 7 hours across.
Nobody knows where it is.
Nobody knows where it
it's
is.
It's another stand.
Okay.
Yeah.
So last year, earlier, I did two trips. So the first one was down south to Almaty. Beautiful. Absolutely
beautiful.
Stunning. Concerts, workshops.
Everyone's got to get to Kazakhstan.
Okay.
Yep.
Last year, in November, I was invited to the Burabay Festival and to Astana, which are right up by the Russian border. And everyone who was there, and it was representatives from loads of countries, were from countries that ended in IA or STAN.
Yeah.
Armenia, Lithuania, Romania, or Stan. So it was Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, Kazakhstan, Pakistan, and so on. However, it was fantastic. Very cultural. I was actually awarded the Aitmatov Medal, which was very humbling.
You were?
Yeah, I was actually very humbled by
fantastic.
That.
Fantastic.
In fact, because it was actually done at a fashion show that I was falling asleep at, and they called my name out. I thought I was going to get ejected from the hall. And they said, come up. And I said, oh, my God, what have I done now? And they said, oh, thank you. It was worth coming out here to Kazakhstan.
Oh, anyway.
Now, I say all this because also we were involved with the Kazakh government and we did a piece about Borte, the long-suffering wife of Chinggis Khan.
Oh.
Chinggis Khan, you might have heard of him. And
very painful. Yeah.
Well, the point is, Kazakhstan is particularly worried because they honestly believe, and it's already been threatened, that after Ukraine, they're next.
They're next because they've got a lot of stuff under the ground.
Yep. Oil rich indeed.
Yeah, very, very.
Indeed. Now, can I mention anything about... Did we mention March 28?
Yes, we've already gone through it.
Did I mention it was on at 7 o'clock at a march in Kuyong Road?
Yes,
it's going to be sensational.
No, I've got the big poster up already.
We've got two choirs and we've got a dance...
We've done all that.
I'm not going to repeat myself.
We have to finish now.
I don't do repetition.
I could sit here with you for 3 days, it's very hot today and we've got to get going because we've got a guest coming.
It's Purim.
We've got to finish that. I wish everyone Purim Sameach.
Enjoy the ears of Haman.
Yeah.
It was Persian.
Hamantashen. Yeah. We've already talked about that.
Oh, okay.
So, Warren, it's been great to have you on as a guest.
It's been, on a scale of 10, what do you reckon?
About 7.5.
7.5?
Yeah.
Good
pretty
stuff.
Good. That's
good
my
stuff.
Favourite.
Yeah.
We'll be back next week because that's what we do.
You do this every week?
Yeah, do this every week.
Do you have a day job?
No, I don't have a day job.
Henry Greener!
Full-time. Thank you very much. Episode number 795. We're approaching 800. Coming up. And I don't know what we're doing for that. We'll probably just collapse. The whole thing will just fall over.
That's quite significant, you know?
Yeah, I don't know what it means, but...
It means there'll be world peace.
There will be world peace.
In 800 years' time.
That's what Purim is all about. That's it. Is standing up, and we are standing up still for Israel and for the Jewish people, and that's what we're all about, because we won't be bullied and we won't be
I want to say something, 30 seconds seriously. Kazakhstan is a Muslim country. I was made very welcome there. The year before, I went to Jordan and performed for the Jordanian royal family. I was very welcome there.
Yeah.
I went to Dubai. Just to know, this thing about coexistence, it can be done. Not such a big deal.
Yep.
If you really want to do it, it can be done.
That's a beautiful way to end the show. We'll see you next week, and we say shalom.
Shalom.
And Purim Sameach.
Chag Purim.
Chag Purim.
Henry Greener, live in the flesh.
Live.
In pharaonic gear. Still Ramses II.
Still alive.
Yeah.